exams. And we are here with Javier Terrero, who is one of the winners of the IELTS Award. And he's only 18 years old. And he's just finished his high school, although you did go for
a gap year.
A gap year he's been to this Kinsel, was the route, the award?
Well, yes, an award, but that was
2013.
Yeah, 2013, but this year I've been working abroad and learning languages. And so I'm going to
prepared. Right. Okay. He's going to tell us about his experience and how he's got to win the award, and in order to help you all to and encourage you to apply for next year. Okay, so why did you decide to study abroad?
Well, I decided to study abroad. In fact, I decided to study abroad 2 years ago when I was in this period with the Cantab, and we were selected to travel to Panama and live with native people there. And with an immigrant community that there are a kind of Indians that were there before Colon arrived and these kind of things. And they had completely a different way of understanding their own social reality was completely different to our social reality, you know, law, economy, politics. So I realized that we are living in an international community, in an international society, and we cannot talk anymore about states that are closed with their own laws and with their own principles and with their own cultures and with their own, because next generation is going to be a melting pot of different people. And in this regard, going to study abroad and especially to King's College, there's going to be a very rich and enriching international community. It's going to allow me to see different perspectives of the social reality, because I really believe that for changing the world, we need to understand it first. And here in Spain, or if you live, well, whatever you live, you only have only one part of it, one perspective. And to get the whole picture, you need to get to know each other, different countries, different people, but to see it in direct. And that's why I want to study abroad.
Okay, that's very good. And can you tell us about how easy or difficult it was to apply to universities abroad, because I suppose, or did you just apply to King's College?
I applied to universities all around the world, so I was on the jury applying to universities, and it is, most part of the universities, they only ask your grades and a personal statement, so it is quite easy. I applied to universities at the Netherlands, in France, UK, United States, and after that, with all the results, I decided to go to King's. Mainly because the Department of Work Studies, I love the Department of Work Studies. But the only advice that I can give you is that what is really important is your personal statement. As long as you have the minimum requirements to enter with your grades, that's not really important. What they are looking for is for motivation, they are looking for effort, they are looking for a way of understanding the world that they like. And it's also important to prepare right, because it is not simply, you know, be there and write a letter of 1,000 lines or whatever, and that's all. You need to read before and to be sure of why do you really want to study this subject. Not only the opinions that you have heard, or maybe because you are you have an idea of what it's about and you think that it is going to give you that job or another. You really need to have a deep reason of why do you want to study there.
Anything you would like to say to them that you might think that will help them?
Yes, there's something.
And encourage them.
Yeah, encourage them, of course. It's a big opportunity, and I'm here, so you can be here, of course, that's for sure. But made the point of the personal statement, it is a very, really, really short personal statement. You have a lot, you have like 5 lines, 6 lines to make the difference, and they're like hundreds of applicants. So completely avoid the ideas that everybody has. I mean, I know that studying abroad will allow to improve my English, and it's fantastic, but I do not mention it. Try to find another reason which is more different, or maybe I would say more personal, because that's really what they're looking for, something completely different, something that they haven't seen before. And with thousands of applications, I think that this is really, really difficult. And after that, in the interview, just be confident, because if you have made it so far, I think that you can, that you will be okay in the interview. But the personal statement, I mean, I don't, it's not that I don't like the process. It is, in fact, it is very interesting how you prepare the process, because you have, you don't have space, you have like 5 lines, so it is very important to make the point in 5 lines, and that's something really, really difficult.
Okay, well, we would like to congratulate you again. And we look forward to hearing from you and your experiences abroad this year. We will certainly be in touch.
Thank you. Okay.